chapter number 12, electricity, we go through the most important law. It is called Ohm's law. Ohm is a scientist which is found the law between it find the relation between potential difference and electric current. It is called Ohm's law. It is the most important law in the physics. It is the basic law, and if you study in higher standard, you already have to calculate with the Ohm's law. Examples. First, we take to study Ohm's law with the activity, with the practically to find Ohm's law. We draw the circuit. We take here the voltage. It is the battery, and we take four cells. We take wire. We take one resistance between wire. We already put voltmeter in parallel combination. We put ammeter in series combination and plug key or a switch. Write it. We take 0.5 meter long nichrome's wire. Nichrome's is the alloy of some metals which is called nichrome is an alloy of alloy is a alloy means mixture alloy of nickel, chromium, manganese and iron. Here the 1 mark question is important. Nickel is an alloy of nickel, nichrome is an alloy of nickel, chromium, manganese and iron. We take wire X and Y. Between the point of X and Y, we put resistor capital R. Ammeter in series combination, while voltmeter in parallel combination. We joint ammeter in series combination while in voltmeter in parallel combination. First we open the plug key or switch on. Here we put, first we put 1.5 volt battery let's write first point is we take 1.5 volt battery in circuit and switch on or open the plug key and note the values of voltmeter and ammeter. Then put another 1.5 volt battery and note the values of capital V potential difference and electric current. Then again in third and fourth, with the help of third and fourth battery, we note the values of V and I. Note all the values in, put all the values in table and find resistance with the help of V upon I. Let's put a table, let's make a table . We first write sequence and then we write number of cell, number of batteries, number of cells. Then we write potential difference, capital V, and write electric current, capital I, and find the resistance V upon I. Here the sequence will be given in 1, 2, 3, 4. Number of cell 1, 2, 3, 4. Potential difference 1.5. You add 1.5 cell in 1.5. So we have 3.0. In 3.0 add 1.5, 4.5. 4.5 add 1.5 is 6.0. Easily, you have to easily remember for it. First understood and then draw the table. So you have to remember it for long time. And when the potential difference is 1.5, we find with the practically the ammeter also shows the values and it is 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4. When we find the dividation with V and I, 1.5 upon 0.1, it is called 15. 3 upon 2, 0.2, it is called 15. 0.5 upon 0.3, it is 15. And 6 upon 0.4, it is 15. Here one thing is notice is that the R is constant and the symbol of resistance is ohm, or you called it omega. Then we draw the diagram and we draw the graph, plot the graph I versus V. So So here we draw here we take the values of V 1.5, 3.0, 4.5, 6.0 in x axis we put the values for V. In y axis we put the values of I 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5 and make the value 0.1. If the potential difference is 0.1, the current is 1.5, the current is 0.1. 3, 0.2, 0.4, 0.3, 6, 0.4. I versus V graph. Here the one thing is, notice that when we join all the points, the arc will be always in straight line. It calls Ohm's law. The graph will be, it is in straight line. And R is constant. In exam you have to draw the diagram in the answer paper, in routine answer paper, routine answer sheet. You don't have to draw the graph in with the substitutory pages, in not in draw like in the mess. You have to like draw in the answer sheet. First you draw the circuit, then give the information. First take 1.5 volt battery, then add 1.5 1.5 1.5. here we take four type of cells and plot the diagram I versus V. Plot the graph between source I versus V. The graph is shows us that when we change the value of potential difference V, the value of electric current is also change with the V. When V shows the values, electric current also show the value. Electric current also change its value. Let's take one example related to Ohm's law. Here the question is complete. You have to draw the circuit, give the information and make a table according to information, plot a graph and then give the conclusion. Now we go through the textual question number 7, which is exercise related to ohms law in question B. Textual exercise question number 7. In question, the information given as it. One table is given. Information is given in the form of table. Here I, here V. Values of I will be given 0.5, 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4. Values of V already given 1.6, 3.4, 6.7, 10.2, 13.2. This much information given in question, and in question ask is plot the diagram between, plot the graph between I versus V, or you called it V versus I, but in question V versus I, but we draw the diagram V, I versus V. And find the resistance of resistor. Find the resistance of resistor. Let's do it. First we draw the graph. In x-axis we take values of V, so we take it for 13.2, so we go through the 14, understood? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 and 14. X-axis. And here we put 0.4, 0.5, 0.5, 0.1, 0.2, 0.4. So we already write the 1, 2, 3, 4. Put the values for it. 1.6 and 0.4, something like here. 3.4, 0.1 in 3.4. So something like here. You have to approximately identify with yourself to point wise. You don't take the graph, something like in mess. 0.3 10.2 something like here, and 0.4 13.2 something like here. Join the points. You saw that 10.2 something like here. You saw that the 1.6, 3.4, 6.7. The graph always will be you always saw the graph in straight line. So Ohm's law is completed. While you don't draw the diagram in straight line in exam, the answer will be wrong. Then we find the resistance of resistor. There will be two methods can be given in the resistance to find the resistance. First is we rub the graph and then find two methods. First, what will be happen? First we draw the diagram and then find the resistance of resistor. The first method is you find the diagram with the slope 1 upon R is equal to 0.4 minus 0.5 upon 13.2 minus 1.6. 0.4 minus 0.5 and 13.2 1.6. Then, here 1.0. Correction board. So we 0.54 minus 0.5, 13.2 minus 1.6. Calculate it. 11.6 minus upon 3.5. Here 1 upon R is given. So R is equal to 3.5 upon 11.6. It will be 3.314 ohm. Here we find, we take one method with the help of slope. Here we first we take 1 upon R is equal to 3.5 upon 11.6. So R is equal to 11.6 upon 3.5 is equal to 3.314 ohm according to first method. Let's do with second method. Here we take the table, draw the table sequence in number of cell. Potential difference V electric charge I, and R is equal to V upon I. Make a table. Put the values of V and I, 1, 2, 3, 4. Number of cell, 1, 2, 3, 4. V is 1.6, 3.4, 6.7, 10.2, 13.2. I is 0.5, 1.0, 2.0, 3.0 and 4.0. When we divide V with I, the first value we can take 3.2, the second is 3.4 multiplication 1, 3.4 and dividation 3.4, then 3.35, then 3.4, then 3.3. What will we do? We multiply, we divide V of n with I. 1.6 divide 0.5, 3.4 divide by 1. So we give the values. Let's find the resistance. R is equal to first V sum of all 3.2, 3.4, 3.35, 3.4 and 3.3. And then divide with 5. So when we calculate 3.2 plus 3.4 plus 3.35 plus 3.4 plus 3.3, we have to find the value 16.65. When we divide 16.65 with 5, we get 3.33. R is equal to, in this sum you already notice the R is constant, something like 3.2, 3.4 is, 3 is constant. Some values can be given 3.2, 3.4, 3.35, 3.4, 3.3. The first method is this and this one is second method. It is Ohm's law is important in the board exam. First we find the Ohm's law, to study the Ohm's law with practically, and then study the textual exercise number, question number 7.